Things are never quite what they seem. We only see the front, without paying attention to the shadows hiding behind it. All the world is a stage. And all the men and women, merely actors in the tragedy that is life. Recently, mysteries that seem so far away from me are getting closer and are starting to show themselves in the light of truth. My name is Rose Hawkins. I'm an inspector of the Juvenile Division of Massachusetts. For several weeks, I investigated the case of a missing girl named Eden. All of this led me to an old and abandoned asylum in the north of the country. But details are blurring out. My recent memories faded away, as if it was hiding behind a cold and wet fog. When I opened my eyes, all I can remember is a man pointing a gun at me and shooting me down. I'm still alive. How is it possible? I'm still bleeding. I need to find something to heal myself.
My name is Noah. If you are listening to this message, it means you finally woke up. You've probably noticed, but it's impossible for us to speak in this place. I can't speak to you, and you can't speak to me. We can only think inside our own little minds, and that's why I use this old recorder to talk to you. I have a deal to propose, but... Hello, Rose. How are you today? My name is Noah. If you are listening to this message, it means you finally woke up. You've probably noticed, but it's impossible for us to speak in this place. I can't speak to you, and you can't speak to me. We can only think inside our own little minds. And that's why I use this old recorder to talk to you. I have a deal to propose, but you need to find me first.
God, she's right. That was more than 10 years ago, and the asylum never opened its doors again.
Thank you.
impossible for us to speak in this place. I can't speak to you, and you can't speak to me. We can only think in silence. You are probably wondering why such a lovely girl like you got into this dark and cold place. Well, my dear, I'm afraid it's your fault. We told you not to trust anyone. Oh, but you probably don't remember anyway. It's one of those side effects caused by the shock that affected your memory. I'm even willing to bet that you don't remember the last few hours. Why did you come to this asylum to investigate? Why did you come alone? What did you find? What happened? And who shot you? So many questions left unanswered. You finally found me. Unfortunately, I don't have all the answers you seek, but I'm sure your memory will come back in a few hours. All I know is that you were seeking a missing child called Eden. I know a lot of things about her, you know? And if you wish, I can even help you find her. But you need to get out first. You won't be able to. That's why I came to you. I don't think the prospect of spending eternity in this place interests you, does it? Of course, I won't help you for free. You'll have to do me a favor. I would like you to help an old friend of mine, a nurse called Dorothy Simons. I would like to pay off a debt I owe her. It's very easy. You just need to find her and set her free. That's your job, right? You find people and try to figure out why they are missing, don't you? That's why I need you, Inspector. Do you see that big door behind me? My access card will open it. It will bring you back to the asylum. Find the nurse and free her. In exchange, tell you where to find the girl you are seeking.
This might be my only chance to get out of this place. I really should find this nurse before she changes her mind.